Hey there, welcome back to those who watched our last video on automating IT tasks using workflows in OpManager. If you haven't checked it out yet, you can find a link to it in the video description. One way IT admins monitor large networks is by categorizing network devices based on department name, location, floor number, criticality, function, vendor, etc. Creating groups of devices helps an IT admin easily monitor and apply configuration changes to multiple devices all at once. This way, the IT admin can reduce much of their manual labor. In this new video, you will learn how to group network devices in OpManager. Let's take a look at an online banking app. A few resources such as an application server, web server, database server, network switch, and router work together to keep the service up and running. By logically grouping these resources, we can reduce app downtime by monitoring for issues coming from the resources the banking app depends on. Now let's see how IT admins can structure and group the resources for this online banking app. First, click on Settings, then select Groups under Configuration. Click the Add button to add a new group. Provide a suitable group name and description and click Next. Select Devices from the drop-down menu. You can select devices manually or choose by criteria to filter and group devices based on device properties. This even applies to devices that will be activated in the network later. For this example, let me select the devices manually while grouping the resources of the banking service. I am going to select the dependent devices from the available members list and move them to selected members list. Click Next and select the devices that determine the health of the group. Click Save. You have successfully created a group for the banking service. Go to Group Dashboard to view the summary. This provides information about the list of devices available in the group and the devices that had problems in the past. As you can see, OpManager helps admins group devices or interfaces together for organized network management, making it easy to push bulk configurations, reports, widgets, notification profiles, URL templates, downtime schedules, alarm suppression, device templates, interface templates, test credentials, and workflows can all be created for groups and subgroups in OpManager. That's it for now. I hope this walkthrough helps you manage your IT infrastructure better. For more information about grouping network elements in OpManager, refer to the links in the description below. Thanks for watching. To stay up to date with the latest videos exploring OpManager's features, subscribe to our channel, OpManager Tech Videos.